So are you thinking about becoming an eye doctor? If so, you're gonna love this video. I'm Dr. Joseph Allen, and I'm gonna share with you the best books in ophthalmology and optometry, the books that helped me stay at the top of my class while in school and still help me in clinic today. Let's take a look. Hey everyone, welcome. I'm Dr. Joseph Allen here from Dr. Eye Health. The channel helps you learn about the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. So if you're new here to the channel, consider subscribing so you don't miss any of my future videos. Also, remember at any point you can check out the show notes and links in the description below for further information, including links to these books that I'm going to be mentioning that are going to help you out a lot. Otherwise, this is kind of a special video. I actually have several viewers that have reached out to me, whether here on YouTube or on Instagram, that they're interested in becoming an eye doctor and they have a lot of questions. So I'm going to be making a complete series answering some of these questions. So if you're one of those people, then make sure you check out the complete playlist. Now, today's video is about the best books in eye care. These are books that I either had to get in school, some of them I didn't have to get, I just got them on my own, that I read on my free time, that pushed me to the top of my class, including books that I still use today for writing publications and, you know, basically just being the best doctor I can be. So book number one at the top of the list that I would ever say is probably Ophthalmology by Yanoff and Duker. This book is giant. It is huge. It's very heavy. Now, there are digital versions of this book. I personally like the hard copy because I like to take notes and highlight in the margins. But one of the main reasons I like this book the most is because it covers just about everything in eye care. It covers just the basic science down to more advanced surgical techniques. There's even a whole like digital course that it comes with that shows you how the surgical techniques are done and actually shows you real cases. A lot of these chapters are written by some of the best minds in all of eye care, and it covers just a wide range of disease. Things from just simple infections like pink eye to the surface of the eye to really advanced retinal diseases. There's actually so much in this book that I bet if you read through the entire thing before you went to school, you might even know a couple of things that your own professors have no idea about. One of the other things I like about books like this, and this is, comes with most textbooks nowadays, is that inside the front cover there's actually an access code that lets you go onto their website and you can pretty much access the entire book remotely, which is fantastic because they have a search bar. So if you're doing any sort of a publication, if you're doing a research paper, or if you're just like, gosh, I remember this one thing from a class, but I don't remember exactly what it said, type it in, boom, there you go. You have every page that disease or word was ever mentioned on. Now, number two on my list is a little bit more of my personal favorite. It's Cornea by, who's it by again? Mannis and Holland. Cornea actually comes in two sets. This is one of two books. It's one of the reasons I got this is because I spent a lot of my time looking at the front surface of the eye. I absolutely love cornea and anterior surface disease. So if somebody has a bad infection, if someone's got a uveitis or just some sort of complication that's going on the front surface of the eye, including surgeries like LASIK or DSEC, or they're having some other disease that needs to be treated. This book covers just about all of that, but more in depth, even more so than the ophthalmology textbook goes. This is actually a book that I guarantee you any sort of cornea specialist, whether they're a doctor of optometry, whether they are a LASIK surgeon, I guarantee you they probably have a copy of this textbook. But just like the ophthalmology book, this one is a newer version, and again, it has an access code online so that you can, you know, use the search tool and find all the answers you need. Book number three is actually kind of special for me because I didn't have to get this book. I actually got it my first year just because it was kind of highly recommended. It honestly made me a way better clinician, especially when I actually got into seeing patients. And that book is the Will's Eye Manual. Now, there's many different versions of this book. I always recommend getting the most updated version because, yeah, science and medicine and changes, and you want to be taking care of people the most modern and best ways instead of doing some sort of older technique that's, you know, out of date and could potentially hurt somebody. Now, Will's Eye Manual is kind of like the cheat sheet version of Yanoff and Duker ophthalmology. Do you remember those spark notes or abridged version? It's kind of like that. It's something that's small enough that you can keep in your book bag, or let's say going from clinic to clinic, or, you know, it's just something handy to have in case, you know, oh geez, that is a weird disease that I remember studying in the book or studying in school, but have never actually seen it. And so if you need to, you can get out of the office and actually go quick flip open to this book and read the quick section and be like, oh yeah, that's that weird medication that I need to prescribe, or I need to, you know, do some sort of a lab work and I just don't remember what it is. This is kind of that cookbook that'll tell you that answer. Now, why this book actually helped me a lot in school is because when I got it my first year, I actually just started reading it on my own. Even when I didn't fully understand what some things were, like medications, I hadn't taken pharmacology yet. Every night before bed, I would just say, okay, I'm laying down before bed, I'm just gonna pick one thing to study. I'd flip open the book to one of the chapters, and you know, some of these aren't even that long, but it was enough that I could read, hey, what is this disease? What does it look like? What are the causes of this disease? What are some of the differentials or other diseases that look similar to it? And then go kind of think to myself, okay, if I saw this in the clinic, what tests would I order? What kind of systemic things do I have to think about? What kind of treatment is needed? So it really was a good way through school, again, even before I started seeing patients, to start categorizing where disease was and how to treat it. And again, I think it's easily digestible. And again, if you're going to school, you know, ophthalmology, the Yanoff and Duker text has all of the information and more. This is kind of the abridged version. At the very least, I would say everybody get this book if you're going into eye care. Now, book number four is actually Neuro Ophthalmology, and this one's by Klein and Ferusen. Now, this book, I got this one in school. This one was, again, highly recommended when I took my neuro course. It's similar to Will's Eye in that it has bullet points, and it's kind of like the cheat abridged version for neuro. Any sort of neuro case that comes into the clinic, if someone's got a nerve palsy, if you're suspecting someone's got a stroke, or if someone has a tumor or something going on neurological, this is kind of that book that's going to walk you through what are the differentials, what are the most important things you need to worry about, what kind of tests you need to order. Do you need to order an MRI? Do you need to order a CT? Reasons why I liked this book, again, because it was light. It was kind of similar to Will's Eye, that it was kind of like a cookbook style. Neuro cases are some of the more tougher cases in eye care, and it's good to have something that'll kind of hold your hand through it. Coming in at number five is The Clinical Management of Binocular Vision. Now, this is actually the third edition by Sheeman and Wick, but this book is really, if you're somebody who loves pediatrics, if you're thinking vision therapy, if you're thinking that, you know, maybe traumatic brain injury, rehabilitation, something along those lines, this book will teach you everything. I got this book because I was in school and I was taking a vision therapy course, and that course was actually more difficult than you would imagine. It came in handy not just in general clinic and in school, but then actually in my residency as well, because I had a lot of patients at the VA who either were having problems with double vision, or, you know, part of my residency was actually in traumatic brain injury rehabilitation, so it really helped me out there. But this book, again, covers a lot of different things, especially about just eye muscle movement disorders, as well as kind of like different processing in our brain of how we see images and how our brain kind of overlaps those images so that you can actually see. But it's all done through kind of a clinical perspective. So it's not just textbook didactic information. It's actually stuff that you can use. And it even has case examples so that you can work through things and really teach yourself how this all works. Now I'm just going to include a few bonus items because these are books that I had in school and helped me a lot there, but it's something I really don't open up anymore now that I've graduated. The first one here is The Clinical Anatomy by Liang Remington. It actually teaches you the basic fundamentals, the foundation that you need for understanding how the eyes work, the anatomy, what part of the eye does what. But it actually has clinical insights, like, hey, if this person is having a certain part of their eye is damaged, and it'll say, oh yeah, because of that damage, you will see this in the clinic. This actually affects how what you will see when you actually have a real patient in front of you. And a lot of these sort of questions are things that are mirrored on board exam. So yeah, good book. Another book that you can consider is Visual Perception, A Clinical Orientation. Now, again, this book I got used more for our vision science courses. It actually has a lot of cool information, just kind of understanding about light and how light interacts with our eyes and how different parts of our brain process vision, you know, explains more of like optical illusions and just kind of weird phenomenons that we see with eyes and vision. It goes really in depth into color vision and color vision deficiencies. So again, this is a very good book and written by just a famous author, Stephen H. Schwartz. So yeah, good book. And the last book on my list is actually Borish's Clinical Refraction. Now, this is actually a book that, again, I did have to get in school, and it is at the bottom of the list here because it is very difficult to read. I find the writing is very dry. It's kind of tough to follow sometimes. If you are someone who knows you're going to go more into, you know, being a doctor of optometry, if you're someone who maybe is just, maybe you're a technician in an ophthalmology clinic and you do a lot of the refractions, if you want to be a master of really doing refraction. That's the part in the clinic when we're asking better one, better two. This book tells you not just how to do that, but all the more advanced tips and tricks that'll really break things down. So this book will teach you ridiculous amounts of information. But again, it's a little dry, a little bit tough to get through. You can see how much it's gotten used because of, you know, I have all this duct tape and there's pages falling out. But again, overall, another book you can consider. So eye health question of the day. Did you find this review of different books helpful at all? And do you have any other questions regarding ophthalmology and optometry? Go ahead and comment in the section below. Let me know what you're thinking. All right, everyone, thanks for watching. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. Share this video with any friends that you know that might be going into eye care. Otherwise, if you'd like to see another part of my entire series about how to become an eye doctor, go ahead and click or tap the screen over here to the side. Or if you'd like to see another cool video from Dr. Eye Health, you can go ahead and click or tap the screen down over here. Again, this is Dr. Joseph Allen here from Dr. Eye Health. The channel helps you with the eyes, vision, finding the best vision products. Keep an eye on it. We'll talk to you soon.